welcome to Eyes to Heaven. I'm Jen, and today I'm here to talk to you about the next sign that God told me to lift up, which is Aquarius, and a little bit of Cetus, and a little bit of Pisces Astrinus, and a little bit of Cepheus, and a little bit of Leptis. But first, I want to talk about the sky principle that I want to bring up, because I've been kind of sprinkling those into my videos. Sometimes I don't have them, but today I wanted to talk about how what I'm speaking about is a macrocosm as opposed to a microcosm, which would be like how the sky affects yourself, right? The microcosm, we are made in God's image, which is a very large image, which is in the sky, right? And so the sky does affect us personally as people. Now, how that is, I'm not going to tell you, I'm not going to pretend to know how that is. Exactly, and I'm not going to tell you to go to an astrologer, because I know they're all, they hang out with demons and stuff, and I'm not going to tell you to look that stuff up yourself unless you are seeking God and looking to know the answers that way. But the macrocosm of God, he sits on this throne, and it is a macrocosm, right? It is a system that creates everything else. And so there are, in between self and where God sits, there's, the nations and the world, right? And they are also affected by the stars in that way. And so it's the same thing, how you can look at prophecy. I spoke about this before. You can look at prophecy as, how it used to apply, how it might apply in the future, which is popular, or how it could apply in the present. In the same way, you can look at the stars. How they applied in the past, how they apply in the future, and how they apply in the present. You can look at the macrocosm and how it affects nations, how the stars affect nations, how they affect people individually. But seek God on your own with that. Like I said, don't be going to astrologers. Now, before I begin with Aquarius, I wanted to read Psalm 46. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof, Selah. There is a river, the streams whereof shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacles of the Most High. God is in the midst of her, she shall not be moved. God shall help her, and that right early. The heathen raged, the kingdoms were moved, he uttered his voice, the earth melted. The Lord of hosts is with us, the God of Jacob is our refuge, Selah. Come, behold the works of the Lord, what desolations he hath made in the earth. He maketh wars to cease unto the end of the earth. He breaketh the bow and cutteth the spear in sunder, he burneth the chariot in the fire. Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the heathen. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge, Selah. So I wanted to read that one, that particular psalm, because it has to do with Aquarius in a way. So what is Aquarius? Aquarius is a picture of God pouring out waters, right? He is the one that pours out the waters. And just like last time, I spoke about how he is the one that makes the boat to go right. When I spoke of Argo Navis, he is the wind, and you have to be holding on to the mast and going in the right direction and holding on fast to make sure that you are going the way that you need to be going. And he's the one that pushes the ruach, right, pushes the wind to help move the boat. Now, I also want to hit Antlia. I didn't talk about that, but when you are not doing the right thing in Argo Navis, you're not going to really move forward. You're just going to kind of move down into the bilge, right? I've talked about that before. Becoming the dregs of the population, right? There's a lot of vanity. And Aquarius is the same way, because it shows a way, God shows a way in Aquarius where people go and they choose either the right path or the wrong path on either side, right? There is the, you're either going to go into the whale and die in the whale, like Jonah, who wasn't doing what he was supposed to be doing, or you're going to go to the fish with gold in its mouth and get that gold, right? And so you have a path to choose. And you can either do the Ten Commandments, you can either do the right thing, or you can do the wrong thing. And now the wrong thing is marked by tumultuous waters, right? There are allusions to water in the scripture, always going back to song and Psalms and the allusions in Psalms. He leads me beside still waters, right? Psalm 23, he restoreth my soul. So when you're in still waters, your soul is being restored. You have peace. You are not part of what is going on with the bulk of people and a lot of tumultuous things that are happening. So as the wind blows the ship, you're either grabbing on and going the right way or you're going the wrong way, and you're being swept away in these waters. And you know, the types of people that are swept away in these waters especially are the ones that mimic what they're supposed to be doing and are not actually doing the right thing. They are, you know, malevolent, you know, wanton, vain type of people. And you know, these people are, you know, they pretend to do Sabbath, you know, they're not, they take it off on Sunday, or they get somebody to work for them while they're supposed to be doing Sabbath, right? All these type of people are a picture of, you know, the moon. There's a picture of a man in the moon who carries sticks on the Sabbath, and you know what the moon does? It affects the water. When you sin, you're going to be thrown into tumultuous waters. You're going to be thrown into dangerous waters because you're not doing the right thing, and the moon is allowed to pull you and push you every which way. And you know, you're not supposed to say a conspiracy to all those who say a conspiracy. You're supposed to step out of the system. That is part of doing the Ten Commandments and setting yourself apart, especially on Sabbath. And that's why I always tell people to be resting on Sabbath, because there is the way in which you should go is just, it is a mark, right? And so you are God's beautiful servant, right? You are, you know, you should be doing what he told you to do. And that is the Ten Commandments. And it is up there in the sky in the macrocosm. And so how is that going to affect you in your real life if you're not doing what you're supposed to be doing? You're going to be swept away in the news. You're going to be swept away with drama, right? You're going to be swept away with the newest craze, what's on the internet, you know? And you can't be that way. You can recognize it and know that it exists, know what's happening, but you can't allow your mind, and you can't meditate on these things. You are supposed to be preparing for big things to happen, and you are supposed to be separating yourself from the multitude. And so, you know, these people that aren't doing what they're supposed to be doing, they're gonna, you know, judgment is gonna befall them, and you just gotta be doing what you're supposed to be doing. So that's Aquarius. It is just a picture of waters, and how, you know, I've spoken about this before too, how your thoughts aren't entirely your own thoughts. And you are fed thoughts. And there is an Indian proverb, which I think is correct. You are basically the wolf that you feed, right? There's two wolves. Which one are you going to feed? And that is true. You can feed your bad thoughts, right? You can feed your bad thoughts and keep having bad thoughts and keep getting swept away. Or you can cut it off, you know, do what you're supposed to be doing and sit down and rest and look into maybe the things that I'm talking about, because this is green pasture, okay? What I'm giving you is green pasture for you to go and look up and make sure I know what I'm talking about, because God gave me and he told me to say this, and this is, you know, I'm not here of my own volition, right? In any case, that's all that I have for that. But I did want to read Isaiah 29, because I brought this up before about Ariel and the Lion of God, right? How, you know, I've alluded to Isaiah 29, and I forgot to mention this in one of my last videos, and then I ended up putting it in the description. But I wanted to go through because it's still very pertinent to what I am speaking on today. So I want to start in Verse 9. So stay yourselves and wonder, cry ye out and cry. They are drunken, but not with wine. They stagger, but not with strong drink. For the Lord hath poured out upon you the spirit of deep sleep, and hath closed your eyes. The prophets and your rulers, the seers, hath he covered. So this is a picture of several of the things I've talked about, right? Where God is putting people to sleep. If you don't want the truth, you're going to be put to sleep. All these seers and stuff, all these people in high places now, because they still exist. Don't think they don't. They are blind. They don't actually know what they're doing, and they are being moved by forces that are under God's control. They don't know what they're doing. And the vision of all is become unto you as the words of a book that is sealed, which men deliver to one that is learned, saying, read this, I pray thee, and he saith, I cannot, for it is sealed. It is sealed. And you know who has the seal? The Lamb. And that is a seal of the sky. And he shows you those things in the sky. And those things that I'm telling you right now, you need to go look it up. This is sealed up, and people don't know it. People talk about this stuff on Sunday. They have no idea what they're talking about because they're not doing the right thing. And they have no way to look into this stuff really, because they have no idea what they're talking about, and they're not doing the right thing. Okay, so verse 12, and the book is delivered to him that is not learned, saying, read this, I pray thee, and he saith, I am not learned. Yeah, that's, I mean, just all the time. Wherefore the Lord saith, forasmuch as this people draw near me with their mouth and with their lips, do honor me, but have removed their heart far from me, and their fear toward me is taught by the precept of men. Yes, it is. All of these people, these Sunday-going people, these people, you know, that say that they know God in other ways, right? These people, they just know what men teach them, and they're supposed to do all of this stuff, you know, cover your wife's hair and freaking tie tzitzit on your robes or whatever. Like, this is precepts of men. Like, God never told y'all to do this stuff. This is extra, okay? And they go around lording over people, and they have no idea what they're talking about. Therefore, behold, I will proceed to do a marvelous work among this people, even a marvelous work and a wonder. For the wisdom of the wise men shall perish, and the understanding of their prudent men shall be hid. That's true. It's hidden now. People don't know. Woe unto them that seek deep to hide their counsel from the Lord, and their works are in the dark, and they say, who seeth us, and who knoweth us? So these are the people that lord over everyone else, too. Surely your turning of things upside down shall be esteemed as the potter's clay, for shall the work say of him that made it, he made me not? Or shall the thing framed say of him that framed it, he had no understanding? Is it not yet a very little while, and Lebanon shall be turned into a fruitful field, and shall be the fruitful field, shall be esteemed as a forest? That's the white ones, okay, the Lebanon, the white ones, maybe the ones that are reflected in the stars in the correct way, right? Maybe. Just a thought. And in that day shall the deaf hear the words of the book, and the eyes of the blind still see out of obscurity and out of the darkness. Please listen. The meek also shall increase their joy in the Lord, and the poor among men shall rejoice in the Holy One of Israel. For the terrible one is brought to naught, and the scorner is consumed, and all that watch for iniquity are cut off, that make a man an offender for a word, and lay a snare for him that reproveth in the gate, and turn aside the just for a thing of naught. Therefore thus saith the Lord, who redeemed Abraham concerning the house of Jacob, Jacob shall not now be ashamed, neither shall his face now wax pale. So Jacob is a picture of Aquarius, by the way, in the patterns of myth. But when he sees his children, the work of mine hands in the midst of them, they shall sanctify my name, and sanctify the Holy One of Jacob, and shall fear the God of Israel, and shall mount up with wings as eagles, friends. Mount up with wings as eagles, and run and not be weary. Okay? They also that erred in spirit shall come to understanding, and they that murmured shall learn doctrine. So that's what we're all hoping, and that's why I'm here. I hope that you listen to me. I hope that you put two and two together and go and seek out the things that I'm talking about. I've got another one after this, and another one after this. So I've got two more again. I'll probably see you next time. Maybe I'll see you again. I hate telling you exactly when I'm gonna be on here again, because it never pans out. It's always not the way I'd hoped. So I'll see you next time, and have a good one, and be good.